Hi, I'm Mike Leckron, director of the University of Wisconsin Marching Band. We've prepared this short video to help people who are interested in coming into the band as freshmen or new people to learn our style, learn how we do things, learn a little bit of the preparation that might be necessary for you to come in and when that first rehearsal starts, be a little bit more ready for what's going to happen the following week. Let's begin with the attention position because it's an essential part of what you are in the band. More or less, it's an attitude we want you to convey. We'll start with the heels together, with the toes out at a 45 degree angle. From that point on, it's essential to keep your torso erect and the shoulders square. Keep a nice straight line through the body, from your shoulders to your heels, with your calves remaining absolutely straight. Stay relaxed. Another important factor in keeping a relaxed look is keeping the weight distributed evenly between the ball of your foot and your heel. It's always very important to keep your shoulders back so you stand nice and tall while keeping your chin up. Look forward into what's going to happen next. The marching style here at Wisconsin goes back to an old style which used to be called the Big Ten style because every Big Ten band used it. Then it became known as the high step. Now our step is a variation of the high step with the raised knee, but it's very different from what most other bands do. If you can master our style, you'll fit right in because the number one thing we look for during your first week is the style. The thing that makes our style unique is a thing we call stop at the top. It's one of the hardest things you will have to master. As you raise the foot, there has to be a momentary, almost split-second hesitation as you bring the foot up to the top. Then as soon as you start to lower the foot, you put it down as you would before. With every step, there's that stop at the top, that hesitation, which may at the beginning look a little mechanical, but eventually you'll get the flow of it and be able to keep that energy that we're looking for, which stop at the top gives us. The first essential is when you lift your leg, the foot is always out in front of you with calves perpendicular to the ground, parallel to that back locked leg, keeping a straight line in both legs. From the moment the leg begins to rise, the toe must be pointed straight down towards the ground. You must really feel the tension in the upper part of your pointed toe. The second essential of our step is that when this knee is fully raised, the thigh is kept at a 45 degree angle. One tendency with younger members is as they raise their leg, the other leg tends to bend. It's important to keep that back leg locked while marching the Wisconsin style. Keeping the back leg locked holds the straight line from your shoulders all the way to your heel, even while you're marching. Another problem that often happens with new members is that they hit the ground too hard with their foot. The feeling as you're marching is that the heel should never hit the ground, although we know that it does. Instead, your weight should be kept on the balls of your feet. Make sure to keep the toe point as the foot approaches the ground. Don't flatten out the foot before it hits the ground. This is a problem we often see in the early rehearsals of the season. Now, when you're marching, we go back to the fundamentals of the attention position. We want that sense of the straight line running down your body to continue, so it's very important to keep your back straight. You can't let your shoulders lean forward, creating a hunched look. Keep them back and your torso in an erect stance. Now, when you're on the field, you'll always be holding an instrument. It can be hard to know what to do with your arms while learning this step when you don't have an instrument. Keep the arms in what I'd call a runner's position and let them gently go with the natural swing of the body. Marking time indicates that there's no movement forward. It's a good practice to learn marking time with your ball of the foot on the yard line so that there's no drifting forward or backwards as you're moving your feet. Now, when we're marching down the field, we're an 8-to-5 band. What that means is we step off with the left foot in a 22.5-inch stride. On every eighth step, we hit the center of the next yard line with the ball of the right foot. You'll hear us emphasize that all season long. The ball of the foot must hit the center of the yard line. The idea of the step off is very important to ensure that you have 8 even steps between the yard lines. If you step off correctly, you won't have to take a huge 8th step to reach the yard line in time. Most new people to the band don't take a big enough first step. Now in this instructional video, we've purposely left out the various turns that we make, the facings that all bands have to learn. And one of the reasons for that is everything that we do is based on the stride. Everything is done is based on marking time, making sure that the foot is in the right position. So again, if you can master that part of it, you come to our week very well prepared and you can easily learn how to turn left, how to turn right, how to do the facings. That's all part of making sure that marching style is in place. Hope this has been helpful to you. And if you practice it, if you want to go to our website to see some further things, I'm sure it'll be very helpful too. We'll look forward to seeing you when you arrive in August.